So the system of equations comes from, so I have AM, just rewriting what we already know, AN XN K naught squared, right, N is equal to 1 to N. The integration is over GRM R prime dr prime PN of R prime dr prime, okay, is equal to. So, this gives us a full system of equations of the form Ax is equal to B, right. The x is a column vector of A1 up to An, okay, and B is a column vector of the incident field at various points R1 Ei of Rn, okay. So, now we know pretty much everything. If I want to find out now, this was my original problem over here, V1, and there is a current source over here. I am standing over here. This is my location R. What is the field that I want to measure? I will write E of R as Ei of R plus K naught squared G of R R prime chi of R prime dr prime. Now, I know this, right, these integrals I know now, I know everything because I have in the previous step I have solved and I have got my E inside the domain, right, this integration was over V2. So, this whole thing is also known. So, what I have got is incident plus scattered is giving me total. Yes, in this expression, what this fellow over here is R belongs to V1 and R prime, of course, the region of integration is shown to be V2. Okay. So, this is the second step, right. So, this was step 2 and what we did over here was step 1.
Then the last integration E over is in E of R prime, right?
Yeah, R prime is in V2, that does not change.
E1.
So, okay, so the confusion is that the equation is actually the same. I have the same equations for step 1 and step 2. The only difference in these equations, I mean, the equation is the same. What I am changing is R. R is appearing here, here, and here. This never changes. When I wanted to solve for ER prime, I needed, so here R prime belongs to V2. So, I had to make sure that R over here also belong to V2. So, in step 1, I made R belong to V2. In step 2, I make R belong to V1 because that is my region of interest. But inside this, this never changes. R prime is always belonging to V2. So, now I know everything. And in fact, in evaluating step 2, there is no problem of singularities because R is always outside over here. So, you are always looking at the distance from this pulse, then this pulse, then this pulse. This is the region of integration, no singularities.
Even if you,
well, yeah, if you put R inside V2, you will get back one of the equations you are already used. So, it is redundant to do that. Okay, so, this was a very quick run through of volume integral equations. I went a little fast because we know all the building blocks. We knew the Helmholtz equation, we knew Green's function, right, and we knew how to deal with singularities. Those were the three building blocks which we are by now very comfortable with. Okay. So, these volume integral formulations, as I stated in the very beginning, when my problem is actually heterogeneous, this is what I will use. The incident field is going to be, so the equations are the same, step 1, step 2, the equations are the same. So, wherever you put R, you calculate Ei of R, whether it is in V1 or V2. It is a numerical value, right. So, it does not matter. So, it will be different in step 1 and step 2 because in step 1 R is belonging to V2. So, you will be finding out Ei inside V2. In step 2, you will be finding out Ei at the location of the observer. So, question about the grid over here? Yeah, okay. So, quick clarification about this grid over here. What am I doing? So, let us look at this equation over here and in particular we are looking at this integral. So g of rr prime, when I do the testing, it becomes this expression, right? This you agree? So here in this Green's function, rm is being held constant because the region of integration is, the variable of integration is my prime coordinate. So rm is fixed over here. R prime is allowed to run over, break up this summation for n pulses. So one pulse after the other. So when I take, let's say, the sixth pulse over here, R prime varies over this pulse. So what is there? There is no singularity to worry about. So G R M is fixed. R prime is varying over this pulse. No problem. I calculate this. But this summation goes over all the pulses. So at some point it will come back to pulse number 1 where RM or R1 lives.
So R prime is only varying over a particular pulse.
R prime is varying over the entire V2, but entire V2 have split up into pulses. So I have to go pulse by pulse. That is how I split this up. Yeah, this is the last slide. Yeah. So in step 2. Yeah. So here exactly. Here is where we will substitute E of R prime is equal to summation of AN PN of R prime. Now this is known.
So after this basically you can know the E of R at any point.
At any point. After this you can know E of R at any point. Yeah, you use the same square square to circle grid approximation. You don't change the way you evaluate this integral. Right? The only thing that changes as the observer location changes is this Green's function. That's all that you have to change.
And the chi?
The chi will not change. The chi belongs to the domain. So, the chi will remain the same. It's non-zero only in V2. So, that will remain the same. The only thing that is changing, the only thing that depends on R in this expression is this guy. Yes, that's where the rho mn comes in. No, so here this rho is rm minus r prime. After I have evaluated the integral, it turns out to be rho mn, where rho mn is equal to this. This is the integration. Here right now r prime is varying, right? And I made it into a new scalar variable. I called it rho. So this became this.
So here xn is known.
Then it should be r.
Xn is known.
Then it
should be r dash dr d theta. So I can write this in terms of r dash dr dash d theta, and then that gets converted to rho d theta. Remember, here this is a vector, it's a two-dimensional integration. I have broken it down into two scalar terms, rho and theta, in polar coordinates. No, the limits of integration are the same regardless of which pulse I'm in, because I have to integrate over the whole pulse. No, so when see over here, rm is being held constant. Right. So this I see. Yeah. So R dash. So over here it looks like I'm integrating over the same pulse. Yeah. But there will be an offset in this depending on which pulse I'm. Yeah. It should be offset inside the Bessel function itself.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it will get. I mean. So it's all in here. Right, so you can think of r dash as rn plus rho, something like that.
Yeah.
That's yeah. So those intermediate steps we have skipped in between. Okay. So these are the references that we have. This is particularly chapter 2.5 of Peterson's book. It's a very nice book. Surface integral we had chapter 8. And for the basic theory, we are referring to these guys. Okay?